Hello friends, we are from Bannari Amman Institute of Technology, Electronics and Instrumentation Department. Have you ever tried talking to your friends underwater? If so, you have discovered that it didn't work very well. How then can people communicate underwater? So, we are here with the concept Underwater Wireless Communication System. It is a technique of sending and receiving messages below water. Even though sound travels well in water, our vocal cords are not designed to generate underwater sound. Due to large attention and absorption, electromagnetic signal does not propagate well in the seawater. Thus, radio waves are not used. Therefore, acoustic waves are used. Acoustic waves are a type of longitudinal waves that propagate by means of adiabatic compression and decompression. Acoustic waves travel with the speed of sound, which depends on the medium they are passing through. There are several ways of employing such communication. The most common communication is used is hydrophones. A hydrophone is a microphone designed to be used underwater for recording or listening to underwater sound. It is based on piezoelectric transducer that generates electricity when subject to the pressure change.
Here is the basic acoustic communication model. The model consists of acoustic transducers and acoustic modems. Acoustic modems are used to transmit data underwater, much as telephone modems are used to transmit data over phone lines. It also converts digital data into special underwater sound signals. These signals are then received by a second acoustic modem and converted back into digital data. Here are some of the factors affecting underwater communication. Multiple path propagation, time variations of the channel, small available bandwidth, strong signal attenuation. These are some of the factors mainly affecting underwater wireless communication. Some of the applications of underwater wireless communications are sonar, marine biology, particle physics. It also helps to provide early warnings of tsunamis generated by undersea earthquakes. Pressure sensors that are deployed on the seafloor can detect tsunamis. Icebergs can also be detected. Underwater data links can be combined with satellite data links to provide data in real time from instruments on the seafloor to scientists ashore. Despite the much development in this area of underwater wireless communication, there is still an immense scope, so more research as a major part of the ocean bottom yet remains unexploded. The main objective is to overcome the present limitations and implement advanced technology for oceanographic research and cope up with the environmental effects on the noise performance of acoustic systems to compete with the future challenges like effective transmission of audio and video signals, etc. Thanks for watching.